All right, guys, welcome to the channel. So today we're in the garage. We're looking at the, this is on my 2021 Chevy Silverado 2500 HD. It's got the Duramax engine. When you have the Duramax engine, it comes with a few things for winter care. Now, it's snowing outside today. It's cold. It's, you know, 35 degrees. And so we're going to take a look at how to use the winter cover and then also this engine block heater cord. So stay tuned. Okay, first thing let's look at is this this heater block cord. So this actually comes with the truck when it's new. It actually has a reusable zip tie on it. You just hold down the little tab. You can push this off. So that's reusable. So don't cut that off. Now this is advisable to use when it's 0 degrees Fahrenheit and below. So below zero temperatures, if your truck's going to be sitting overnight and below zero temperatures, get this out and plug this thing in. It's going to help with keeping the block warmer. It's going to help ease the starting process when you start it up in the morning, for example. Okay, so it's probably, you know, it's probably about a 8 to 10 foot long cord here. It does have a cover here. The nice thing on these new Silverados is this is the engine block heater outlet is right down here on the driver's side below the bumper. So we're down here by the bumper. We can just pull this up. Okay, there we go right there. Plugs in right there. And then we just plug in the other end just to a standard outlet. You probably need an extension cord. One thing that's interesting, though, is that it says to not use the engine block cord, to use the engine block heater inside of a garage or a carport, not to have it inside any kind of enclosure or structure, which I thought was interesting. So you're not to use the heater, the engine block heater, unless you're outside in a wide open area. It says that property damage could occur if you use this inside of a structure like a garage. So use it if you're outside. So you'll probably want to carry an extension cord with you. So that way, if you have to use it, you're parked outside, you need to run an extension cord to, you know, the nearest outdoor outlet that you have available. Sometimes that may not be possible. If you're parked in like public parking, it may not be an option. You may not be able to find power to hook this in. So you may have to do without it. But if you're parking your truck, for example, outside on a regular basis, you don't have a garage or a carport anyways, this is a good way to keep it warm. So in those early mornings, those real cold mornings below zero, it's going to start up a lot easier. All right, we'll just put that back in the truck. Okay, let's talk winter cover. This is a cover that goes over the grille for cold weather situations. So let's get this put on and we'll talk about it. Okay, putting it on is pretty straightforward. Obviously the felt side is going to be facing the grill. It does say, it does have an up, it shows up, and it says to start in the middle, and these top clips are just going to start right here at the top of the grill. It's going to work around that way. It's going to clip under there. This is going to clip there. And then on the bottom part, it's going to clip into, I call it about the third hole up right behind that bar. Okay, so we've got the cover. We've put it on, and I wanted to go over some parameters as to when and how we should be using this cover. The instructions aren't super clear on how to install it. I'll go over that in just a minute as we take it off. But it's just a kind of a vinyl cover. It protects the grill from cold weather, from cold air, from snow. And I'm just going through kind of the Duramax engine supplement manual here, and I want to just see when is it advisable to use this cover and, you know, how it should be used. Now, the rule of thumb is if it's 23 degrees and lower in temperature, Fahrenheit, so 23 degrees Fahrenheit or lower, you should put the grill cover on. Okay. Also, if you're towing, you shouldn't be using this above 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So if it's above freezing, don't use this if you're towing. And it also says for heavy snow. So it's really heavy snow, throw this thing on there. It's going to help keep all that snow, ice accumulating inside of the radiator. That's going to, you know, affect the cooling properties of it. It also says don't use the cover if you have a snow plow mounted. So if you're plowing snow, keep the cover off. Because that's going to block some of the airflow already. And also, it's not advisable to cover this bottom area here. So this below the bumper here needs to be kept open. It's really just this grill part right here in the front that we need to cover when it's cold. This is for a 2020 and newer HD truck front grill cover. So whether it's High Country, Custom, LT, LTZ, any of those trims, the cover is going to be the exact same, and the mounting points might be a little different. Now, this is the custom trim. This is one of the lower trims, but on the back of the cover are these little hooks, and they just hook right into the top. So how I'm interpreting that it goes on is it hooks on in the very top right up under here, hooks in right up underneath the lip of this, the top of the grill, and then there's one that a forward-facing clip that's going to clip there, because there's a little U-shape cut out right here, and this seems logically the only way that this cover is going to fit on here. But at the bottom, there's a little flap that's going over the hook. So if we see here, the hooks are right here. So I'm not installing them all the way to the bottom. It's actually on this first. It's actually being hooked in right on this level on the grill. So it's almost the third opening from the bottom, where these hooks are going in. They're hooking right behind the edge of this grill right here. You see that one come out there. Okay, so when this goes down in there, it's hooked in right behind the grill right here. This is just hooked in there. So because there's also going to be a lot of airflow here, as long as it's just snug and tight, it doesn't have to be, you know, perfect, the wind resistance is going to keep it flat against the grill. Also, you want to make sure that it's not, that all of the clips are hooked in, so that it's not flapping around, because if one of these clips come loose and it's flapping around, it could cause some damage to the painted surfaces of the grill, especially like this one right here. This one needs to be hooked in like so, and you don't want that coming undone. So just getting all those clipped in, pretty straightforward. Also, it helps if it's warm. Keep this in the cab of your truck, so that way that it stays warm. That way, if you need to throw this on, it's been kept warm. It's not like in the bed of your truck where it's going to be, you know, frozen shut and it's going to be hard to get on. So if the warmer it is, the easier it is to install. And then just take it off. You know, temperatures get above 23 degrees. It's not snowing. Take it off. You don't want the engine to overheat. But those are kind of the guidelines for the cover. I did find that it's easier to lift the hood up to be able to get access to installing it, because really the hood's coming over the edge right here, and it's harder to get these top hooks in. But you still have some air. There's still some airflow into the engine here, if you can see through this area right here, down below. So you still have some airflow here. It doesn't need that much airflow when it's, you know, 23 degrees or less. If it's, you know, 10 degrees outside Fahrenheit, it's going to be pretty cold. The engine doesn't need to be cooled that much. So that's where the cover would come into play. So hopefully that was helpful information. Hopefully it is. I'm going on a road trip here in a couple weeks, where it could be some treacherous weather. It's really cold weather, and we might have to throw this on. So stay tuned to the channel. Be sure to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you in the next one.